गवर्नर ऑफ उड़ीसा प्रोफेसर गणेशी लाल जी, यूनियन मिनिस्टर ऑफ पेट्रोलियम एंड नेचुरल गैस एंड स्टील श्री धर्मेंद्र प्रधान जी, मिनिस्टर ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ उड़ीसा श्री नावा किशोर दास जी, मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट श्री जुआर राम, डायरेक्टर ऑफ एनआईटी राउरकेला प्रोफेसर अनिमेश विश्वास जी, मेंबर्स ऑफ द बोर्ड, टीचिंग एंड नॉन टीचिंग स्टाफ, माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इट गिव्स मी इमेंस प्लेजर टू बी हियर इन द 18th कन्वोकेशन ऑफ एनआईटी राउरकेला. आई फील डिलाइटेड टू नो दैट एनआईटी राउरकेला इज सेलिब्रेटिंग इट्स डायमंड जुबली दिस ईयर. This area of today's Odisha has been immensely rich in history and culture. It has been the cradle of scientific approach since early times. Built about 800 years ago, the Sun Temple at Konark is an example of perfect blend of art and science. I am looking forward to my visit to the temple tomorrow. It is listed among UNESCO's World Heritage Sites in India. Odisha is associated with the rebuilding of a nation after independence. It was here in Raurkela that one of my illustrious predecessors, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, the first President of India, dedicated to the nation the first blast furnace of a large steel plant in India. As one of the first industrial urban centers in India, the city has kept pace with modernization. As the second largest government-run technology institute in eastern India, NIT Raurkela has made significant contribution to the field of engineering and technology. For over six decades, this engineering college has been enriching the pool of technical professionals in the country. In 2002, it was given the status of National Institute of Technology. I am told that the young students are being exposed to innovative methods of providing engineering solutions to the issues facing our society and the country. I am pleased to know that NIT Raurkela has students from all over India and also from other countries. Pleased to know that NIT Raurkela has students from 33 out of the total 36 states and union territories in India. I am told that students of 17 different countries are also enrolled in various academic disciplines. Thus, the community of over 7,000 students studying in this beautiful 700-acre campus represents rich diversity. It increases cross-pollination of learning and promotes understanding between different cultures. It also strengthens people-to-people ties between nations. Ladies and gentlemen, its 25,000 plus strong alumni has a large number of corporate leaders, academic and research institutes in India and abroad. I am sure that the alumni of this prestigious institute will be a source of inspiration for the students here. I am sure that the students graduating today will strengthen the rich legacy of this institute. Dear students, graduation is an important stepping stone in your life. I am sure all of you have worked hard to reach this stage today. I am sure you are eager and excited to contribute to the world and bring about change in the lives of the people. Today, you are taking countless memories with you. I have been told that your vibrant campus is full of extracurricular activities. There are a large number of clubs engaged in debating, dramatics, music, and other cultural activities. I have also been told about some interesting names like Mavericks and Pantomime. I have also been informed about the canteen, which is interestingly named as Hexagon. And the other canteen with a serious name, Homi Bhabha Canteen, has been naturally abbreviated as HB Canteen for popular uses. But beyond the little joys and sorrows you take away from here, there is a huge responsibility on each one of you to pay back to the society and the country which have contributed to your education and success so far. Some of you will be joining job responsibilities while others may pursue higher studies. The stage of life in which you find yourself today is usually full of dreams and aspirations on the one hand and uncertainties and apprehensions on the other. This is also the time to make major life decisions. Starting a new job, pursuing your dreams, supporting your family, or starting a new one. While doing all this, I urge you all to introspect. What are the values and principles you stand for? What is the kind of career you want to pursue? By far the most important point of introspection is what kind of person you want to become. I am sure everyone wants to be a good citizen, a citizen who always keeps the interest of the country uppermost in his mind. I would suggest that throughout your life, you should always look at the famous talisman of Mahatma Gandhi. I quote, "Recall the face of the poorest and the weakest man or woman whom you may have seen and ask yourself if the step you contemplate is going to be of any use to her. Will she gain anything by it? Will it restore her to a control over her own life and destiny?" Unquote. I advise you to never judge your success only in terms of material gains. You don't have to limit yourself by the pressures of conventional notions of success and societal pressures. You need to figure out what you really want to do in your life. Choose to do what gives you satisfaction and meaningfulness. Do what takes you closer to your aspirations. Do what makes your families proud of you. Plan for yourself a fruitful and productive path ahead. Dear students, this is also a moment of joy and satisfaction for your families and friends, guardians and mentors who have been of immense support in your journey. I congratulate all the degree recipients and model winners present here today. I am told that out of 7,116 students studying here, about 1,518, that is about 21%, are girl students. I noticed that out of 7 gold medals today, 3 have gone in to our girl students. As the President of India, I happen to be the visitor of about 150 central institutions. In most of the convocations I attend across the country, I notice that our girls are outshining our boys and winning more gold medals in liberal arts, humanities, medical sciences, law, and several other areas. This is indeed a heartening trend and reflects the potential of our daughters. However, it has been observed that the enrollment of women in technical and scientific disciplines is low.